Last September, this 12-year-old girl is said to have been defiled by her teacher and a head teacher of a school in Mitiana. She's one of the other three children said to have been defiled by the same man.
We have recorded statements from the girls, very young girls, one is 8.
Sexual violence is the second common abuse of children in schools after physical torture. The other form of violence is emotional violence. According to a report released by Plan International and the Uganda Law Society, older boys suffer mostly physical torture like corporal punishment. Yet older girls suffer at the hands of sexual perpetrators. Children with special needs, war children, those affected with HIV, among others, mostly suffer emotionally in schools. However, the lack of coordination in the legal system has limited the effectiveness of the law in child protection, which the report findings recommend.
We need to have a holistic look at child protection, how we prevent it, how we respond to it, and how we rehabilitate the victims of violence. And similarly also, it recommended that we must have coordination across sectors. We must have coordination across institutions.
Community acceptance of violence, some cultural practices against children, complacency in children issues, limited outlook on policies, among others, are also some of the limitations in fighting abuse despite the presence of the law.
We don't have child protection policies or guidelines, and these need to be developed. Once they are developed, and has to be a participatory process, they need to define and identify different forms of violence, and then the children have to, students or pupils have to get involved.
Violence in schools not only leads to obvious signs of physical abuse in children, but often has implications for children's psychological, emotional and social development. Irene Namialo, NTV.